Hello, BCC kids. This week we'll be talking about fruit of the spirit. But before we get started, we have a fun trivia game for you.
Fruits and vegetables trivia. How many seeds does a strawberry have? 300, 200, 600, 20. Let's ask a strawberry for the answer.
200 seeds I have, yes I do.
Which one has more vitamin C, an orange or a kiwi? Let's ask a kiwi for the answer.
I have more vitamin C.
Do carrots improve our night vision? Let's ask a carrot for that answer.
Nope, I don't help with night vision, sorry, nope.
And the last question, what was the first vegetable to be grown in space? Let the vegetable speak for himself.
I am the amazing space potato. Yeah.
Story time.
Presenting the fruit of the spirit.
In the Bible, God teaches us about the fruit of the spirit. I'm not talking about the fruit you eat. It is talking about how we act when we have the spirit of God in our hearts. Or another way of saying it, what is the end result? For example, the fruit or end result of brushing our teeth is we have clean teeth. What about the fruit of exercising? We get stronger. The first fruit of the Spirit is love. We can be filled with love for God and for other people. Another fruit of the Spirit is joy, to be content with wherever God is leading. Peace is another fruit of the Spirit. We have no worries, we don't feel angry or stressed, when our hearts can rest in God. Another fruit is patience. We can be calm and trust in God's timing. Or how about kindness, how we treat others? Gentleness is also a fruit of the Spirit, how we can be kind and caring to other people. Another fruit is goodness. We can focus on good things and do good things. Faithfulness is another fruit of the Spirit, and it's how we trust and believe in God. And self-control is the last fruit of the Spirit. That means we can say no to something that isn't good for us. God loves us and wants to bless us with good things. Let's be fruity. Okay, time for a little quiz. Are you showing fruit of the Spirit?
Okay, BCC kids, are you ready for some questions? Let's see how fruity you are. Here we go. So, you hear a friend is sick, so you stop by and you try to cheer them up. Is that being fruity? Or not? Yes, definitely. You're showing love, kindness to your friend. Okay, next one. You're standing at the lineup to get water from the water fountain and you're getting impatient, so you push your friend ahead of you. Is that being fruity? No, you're not really showing fruit of the Spirit, are you? Next one. Your sister, she's crying and you don't know why, so you go over and you try to comfort her. Is that being fruity, showing fruit of the Spirit, or not? Yes. Yes, of course, you're being caring and loving. Okay, last one. Your parents buy you a full bag of chips and then tell you to share it with your siblings, but instead you eat the whole bag. Is that being fruity or not? It's not being fruity, right? You're not showing self-control, even though chips are yummy and your parents asked you to share them. Okay, good work, BCC kids. Thank you.
Ephesians 5, 22 and 23. The fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, gentleness, faithfulness, goodness, and self-control. So to review, the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Now God's goal is for all of his children to be more like Jesus. So if we ask for help from the Holy Spirit, he will help us to be more fruity. And we can learn from friends, from teachers, from parents. Let's all do this together.
I'm gonna run, run, run to his love, love, love. I'm gonna sing, sing, sing to God's Son. I'm gonna shout, shout, shout the name of Jesus. He is the one I trust. When I'm alone, when I'm afraid, I know that he is with me every day. He's by my side, he hears me when I pray. Jesus. Jesus, I trust in.